there are lights, bigger lights, and then there's Hong Kong. The world's big cities offer culture, convenience, and a cosmopolitan way of life. Living in a city, especially like this, can be anything but easy. Property prices are some of the highest in the world. The city's battle with air pollution is well known. With so much development, there's also the noise pollution. Now an entirely different problem. It's trying to live in a city of lights, lots of lights. Bustling with business in the heart of Mong Kok, night becomes day when the lights get switched on. This is about as bad as it gets. And remember, there are people living up there trying to sleep, if they can. Wesley Wai couldn't take it and had to move. But not before he produced a video, a combination of still photos that dramatically showed the effect of living here. He called the video the Lucifer Effect. I had insomnia, he says, and if my blinds were open, I didn't have to turn on my lights. He says the blinking went well into the night, as late as 4 in the morning. The problem is, as the television picture keeps changing, the light reflects onto the building opposite. It's like living in an amusement arcade. You might ask, why would anyone choose to live on a street like this? With soaring property prices, Wesley says it's all he could afford. Professor Henry Chung has been studying light pollution for more than a decade and says not only is excessive light a real nuisance, it's a waste of energy. So what would you do? Would you switch them all off?
It's a good idea, but of course we have to strike a balance. That's why I think the government has to do something. The legislation, try to control the maximum brightness produced by all these lights and check the brightness around the area. Then it's the best way to control light pollution.
While there's been debate, there's currently no regulations in place to curb light pollution.
It eventually starts to hurt the eyes, doesn't it?
Yeah.
This is Causeway Bay, a popular shopping district. And don't be mistaken, people are living here as well. So, how excessive is the light tonight? Professor Chung is armed with his light meter.
8:20 at night, what do you consider to be acceptable out here?
At most, 500 lux.
500 lux?
Yeah, at most.
At most?
At most.
Really?
Yeah.
Right, come on. That's not bad.
Not bad here.
Quite good. 448, not bad, all right.
Yeah, okay, let's start.
So there are 2,600, which effectively is daylight, and if you want to see the culprit...
There's the daylight.
There it is.
What's made the situation worse is advertising. To capture someone's attention, you'll bring in the cash. Of course, you don't want to be outshone by the competition.
It's a snowball effect. Say, for example, this shop, okay, use a strong light, then another shop will use a stronger light. Why not just to reduce the brightness of the whole area?
While the city's glistening skyline's been a draw for tourists for years, now even Hong Kong's chief executive recognises action needs to be taken.
We realise that we have to do something about it. If you look at the commercial areas, it's pretty bright. I think it becomes offensive at times. So we are now introducing gradually regulation restriction to make sure people do have a quiet night and not be disturbed too brightly on nights.
The Environment Bureau has proposed the government switch off decorative lighting by 11 p.m, educate the public about energy waste and investigate complaints. That would be a welcome move for Wesley, who doesn't care to be back in the old neighbourhood. He says just standing here gives him anxiety. Stress that could be avoided and the city made more tolerable, more livable, if they'd only turn down the lights. Richard Quest, CNN, Hong Kong.